Well, he's the actor we'll claim as an Australian who played Friedrich Von Trapp in The Sound of Music.
Well, now that there's just us, would you please tell me all your names again and how old you are?
I'm Lisa. I'm 16 years old and I don't need a governess.
Well, I'm glad you told me, Liesl. We'll just be good friends.
I'm Friedrich. I'm 14. I'm impossible.
Really? Who told you that, Friedrich?
Fräulein Josephine. Four governesses ago.
Nicholas Hammond was also the world's first live-action Spider-Man, but now he's turning from hero to villain, you could say, playing Sebastian for the Cinderella musical. And Nicholas is in our studio right this second. It's so nice to see you.
It's such a pleasure.
Thank you,
Sarah.
Thanks.
Great to have you here.
Really sorry nice. That we have to play that every single
yeah.
time.
All right. It's absolutely fine. I still love seeing it. Aww. We all do. We're all still proud to have been in that film. All of us, I think.
In fact, before we get to the great news about Cinderella, can you tell us about this lovely moment? Serenading Dame Julie Andrews, I think. Let's have a look and you can tell us what's going on here.
Well, this is the opening of the American Film Institute Lifetime Achievement Awards. And I give a little talk there where I start the awards the whole night. There's actually a story behind that. That was meant to be Morgan Freeman, and he tested positive for COVID an hour before the show.
Oh, my gosh.
So we revamped the whole opening with me to do a quick little rewrite and then did a sing-along. And then and the whole audience, the whole Dolby Theater where they hold the Oscars, everybody there was singing Do Re Mi.
Oh,
you know,
magic.
It was kind of wonderful in a way.
Does it blow your mind that there's so much love for this movie all these years
it
on?
Kind
decades
of does.
On.
Yeah, to see, well, I mean, that was a good example to look out at that room of, you know, famous people, you know, pop singers and whatever. And not only do they know every word, they're just loving singing everyone from Carol Burnett down to, you know, teenagers.
Wow.
Yeah, it was a great fantastic. Night.
Yeah, I've heard my mum sing it and I've heard my daughter sing it. It's fantastic. Yeah. In fact, Dame Julie Andrews is connected to your new show too.
Well, she is because it was actually written, Rodgers and Hammerstein wrote Cinderella as a television musical for Julie Andrews.
Wow.
She was the first Ella to play Cinderella. And so when I told her I was doing it here, first in Melbourne and now Brisbane and Sydney, she laughed and thought, well, now it's come full circle.
Yeah, there's a beautiful synergy here.
Yeah,
it's lovely. And you're used to playing the hero, of course, so in Spider-Man. But switching to villain mode, was that a stretch?
No, I don't think so, because I don't think a villain thinks they are the villain.
Yeah,
I think
true.
Villains actually are quite convinced that what they're doing is exactly right. I think we see that in politics today.
Yes, that's true.
But so I think Sebastian is absolutely sure that his way of running the country is the right way, and don't let this girl tell you what to do to his prince that he's raised. And he's like a father figure also. I mean, he's raised the boy who is an orphan, and now this girl's come along who's telling him all kinds of things like, do things for poor people, which my character is saying, no. Keep all the money for yourself.
Yeah. What's it like being back on actual stage, performing live on stage?
Well, it's fabulous. Mm. After 2 years of COVID and the theatre being in such a dark, difficult time, you know, the other night in Melbourne at the Regent, you walk out on that stage and there's not an empty seat and it's packed to the rafters and they're cheering and they're laughing and they're having the most wonderful time, you know, and on their feet at the end applauding, and you just think, this is great. It's just great. And I love doing it. I've been working on stage since I was 11. And I don't ever want to stop.
A fair few whacker shows you do a week as well, right?
Eight a week. Yeah. And we do a lot of matinees because a lot of young people come to this. So there's plenty of opportunity. I would say anyone from about six up, you know, would enjoy this very much. Younger ones might if they're kind of very cluey. But from six up is a good age. Six to 106.
That's it.
But you tick every box. My son is only three, but he's just seen Spider-Man. And now he's going to know that I was here with you. So
well,
I'm the hero for
today. Well, bring him to Cinderella.
Of course I will. Of course he'll love that too.
Yeah.
You've got so many great focus groups that you hear about, Nicholas, as well. You've got Tarantino movies as well. It's all happening for Nicholas Hammond. You can catch him in the Cinderella musical in Brisbane and Sydney. For tickets, head to cinderellamusical.com.au. Thank you, superstar, for coming in to chat.
Thank you very much. And you'll love it, Sarah, because it's not as long as The Sound of Music, which we all know you thought was
too
long.
You just needed a half time. I've seen the whole movie, though.
Have you now seen it all?
I have, and it is...
They do escape at the end, you know.
It is a glorious movie, and I can see why it's still endures. So
well, I'm glad you saw part two, finally.
It was such a pleasure to finally meet you and have you in the
studio. Really nice to see you both.